Whenever we would eat water, we would stand close to it. One day, it was winter, I was having breakfast. Suddenly I could hear hey dad, I had an electrical shock. He is 30 years today. Do you think he would do the same thing? No. Today it's my turn to, I cut my finger, my son, what medicine should I use? He's a medical doctor today. Okay. And I may cry and ask him, not because I am immature, because both of us are mature now. Maturity means you don't behave like a child. You behave in a balanced manner. You know what is good, you know what is evil, and you know how to choose that which is good. So the scripture says that so that the man of God may be mature. You don't become mature by reading Dale Carnegie or all these do-it-yourself books. There is nothing wrong in reading those books. Many of them contain a lot of gems. How to overcome fear and worry. Some of those books do contain some real good gems. But you don't become mature by reading them. You become mature by reading and studying the scripture. And when you read and study the scripture, if you read and study it properly, it pierces deep into your heart. It not only gives you biblical truth, it also pierces into your heart. And gradually you move on towards maturity. I'll give you an example. Very childish example. But we all have our own childish sides. When I was a school student, the sign of manhood among us was the ability to smoke. And many of my friends secretly used to smoke. Secretly means their parents would not know, but we knew. So many of us Christians, we would go to our church and ask our teenage class instructor, Sunday school instructor, uncle, is it a sin to smoke? I asked this question maybe 100 times to 100 different people because I was over curious. Many of them gave answers from their human wisdom. One of them said, if the Lord had wanted you to smoke, then he would have put a pipe here for the smoke to go out, and this. All these answers look very nice, very attractive. They look more attractive to the guy who presents these arguments to the children. Finally, I asked the same question to one of my uncles at Chennai. He immediately opened 1 Corinthians 10:31. He said, read it. It says, therefore, whatever you do, whether you eat or drink or do anything, do it for the glory of God. He did not say whether it is right or wrong. He read me a scripture. He read me the right scripture. And he said, Sonny, if you feel that this glorifies God, you go smoke 100 packets a day. I'll not come and question you. And he said, son, if you think that it is not going to glorify God, don't do it. He also said, if you are unable to decide, then wait till you can really understand whether it would glorify God or not. I tell you, my young friends, 100 teachers had answered my question before that, but those answers came from human wisdom. They came from human reaction. They came from human tradition. But this one uncle gave me the scripture. I asked him, he gave me the right scripture. He presented the right scripture. I immediately had the answer. That's why the Bible says that if we have to be mature, that's going to happen only when you get the scripture, when you get scriptural truths. This morning I had a discussion with some of the young men here. And that is one thing I repeatedly emphasize to them. Whenever we teach a principle, the teacher ought to be able to demonstrate it from the scripture. If you are not able to demonstrate it from the scripture, why speak it in the first place? Go back to the scripture and study. Oh, you will say, when young people come and ask me if I don't, I am not able to give an answer, they would be offended. No, they won't be offended. Don't destroy them with a human answer. Rather, tell them, hey, that's a new question. I never thought about it that way. And therefore, let me think a few minutes about that. And then, trust in the Lord to give the answer and give this answer to them. And my dear young friends, if somebody gives you an answer from tradition, from emotion, from cultural values, or from personal opinion, that's not scripture. Please insist that answers come to you from the scripture, because ultimately it is all scripture which is inspired by God, not all human thought. And anybody who teaches you, he should teach you scripture. And to anyone who you ask a question, you should insist that they give you a scriptural answer, because all scripture is inspired by God, and only scripture is profitable for doctrine, reproof, correction, instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature. Hey, girls, you may say, uncle, that applies only to the boys. We are not men. Okay? Little bit of diversion. The word of God uses the word man in a generic sense. Okay? Generic means human being. That human beings who are in Christ Jesus might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Now, what exactly is the meaning of thoroughly furnished? That's a place where we are going to pause for a few minutes. You all know what happened when they came to arrest Lord Jesus. There was a fisherman. He thought that the little dagger he had, he would pull it out and he would annihilate an entire army and he would defend his teacher. And all what he was able to do was cut an ear. You don't use a dagger to cut an ear, do you? You have to be a fool to carry a dagger and cut an ear. And you don't protect your guru, you don't protect your Lord by cutting a man's ear. See, the problem was, he was an expert. He was an expert fisherman, not a swordsman. He had never handled a sword or a scimitar. He had only seen that swords are used to cut necks. He tried to do so, and he ended up cutting an ear. He was not thoroughly prepared to use a tool. Thoroughly furnished means you have your tools and you know how to use your tools. Have you heard stories of men who were armed? Revolver here, gun in hand, and some little guy comes and just pulls out a gun and fires and kills him. Why? Because this man who was loaded, he did not know how to pull out a gun and fire in the first place. He did not even know how to release the safety lock from the revolver. He was not thoroughly equipped. Thoroughly furnished means thoroughly equipped. Each one of us has to be thoroughly furnished. Okay, I'll give you a very illuminating example. Have you heard of Christian Medical College, Vellore? Everybody who has a chronic disease which nobody can heal, they run to Vellore, isn't it? So, in my town in Madhya Pradesh, we had a sister. She had a little bit of problem. So, she went to the doctor and the doctor said it's serious. He prescribed a tablet. And she had some healing, but after about 3 days, she had another problem. She went to the doctor, he prescribed a second tablet. And then after another week, she had a third tablet. And eventually, in a space of about 2 months, she was consuming about, say, 8 or 10 tablets, 8 or 10 different kinds of tablets, and still she was not whole. Then two of the uncles, one was my dad, another brother, they said, immediately you go to Vellore, because now you have 10 tablets, and within 1 year you will end up having 100 tablets, and eventually you will have to bring the whole medical store into your house, and still you will not be whole. So immediately we packed them to Vellore. She and her husband went to Vellore. And they went to a physician. Now these doctors at Vellore, they are very experienced. So the doctor looked at the girl, the doctor looked at the symptoms, and he looked at the prescription, and he hit the roof. He said, whoever prescribed these medicines to you, his medical license should be revoked. And he said, stop all medicine. All what you need is Crocin, paracetamol, Tylenol for 1 week. Tylenol is a non-prescription drug, you know, all of you know, isn't it? A doctor doesn't have to prescribe. All what she needed was take it for a week. She took it for a week. She was whole. She was normal. What was the difference? He was a doctor. This guy was also a doctor. But this doctor at CMC Vellore, he went through a mill to prepare himself as a medical doctor. And then he worked under some of the most qualified doctors. And when he was an intern, he had to work like a donkey, listening to all scolding that came from seniors. He had to examine thousands upon thousands of patients. And in that process, he became thoroughly furnished or thoroughly equipped. My young friends, each one of us needs tools in life. Tools to examine. Tools for decision making. Tools to intensify our actions. And when the scripture says that, the scripture makes us thoroughly furnished unto all good works, what it is saying is that like this doctor who was very thoroughly instructed and trained and who was mentored, in the same way the scripture is going to enter your mind, it is going to enter your heart, it is going to pierce deep, it is going to make you mature. And it is going to equip you thoroughly so that if tomorrow somebody comes and asks you a question, you are able to give an answer, or you are able to at least look in the right place for an answer. Many of you would be going to colleges very soon. There